first. That was the only goal of the opening 20. Back to the line to Rafalski. Good play over to Lidstrom. Shoot, score!
No goal.
Jeez. Holmstrom called off in front. And he's going to go to the box, too. This just won't be coincidental contact. Incidental contact is going to be, I believe, a Holmstrom penalty. Mike Babcock saying, what else is new? What else is new? Well, almost in Don Cherry fashion, throwing his hands up, saying, oh, Tomas Holmstrom in front. We're never going to get that call. Well, now he wants the referee to come over. He wants a word with him. What, Holmstrom's got position there, Mick.
That is about
And he's outside
brutal.
The crease.
That is as brutal as it gets now that I see the overhead and the replay. Rene punched him in the back of the head.
Absolutely.
He's standing at the top of the crease. That is an awful, awful call in that situation if the referee saw what we just saw.
Let's take it back March 19th.
That was different.
No goal again.
A different way. But also to call him a penalty on this one. And let's see here. My.
That was March 19th. And I'll tell you what. Tomas Holmstrom told me after the game, Pekka Rinne told him, you got robbed.
Oh, no kidding.
During the game, he told him that. And again today, it's reputation.
Boy, oh boy.
That is unbelievable.
Holmstrom can't get a break. Kyle Raymond, the referee, when he was hauled down in a breakaway and no call against Chicago the other night. Unbelievable.
Rafalski scaled it on back. That's Zuka Cross. Lidstrom is ready.
Well, the look of disbelief by Mike Babcock, the head coach of Detroit Red Wings. Johan Franzen was standing right in front of J.S. Jagr. The play by Brian Rafalski, he gets it back to the point. Datsyuk sets the table and the shot by Nicholas Lidstrom. There's Holmstrom.
Oh my goodness.
That's, I thought it was Franzen, but it was Holmstrom.
And you know what? He's outside the blue paint. He backs right out. I mean, oh my goodness.
This is the subtle contact, almost the backside of Holmstrom.
Yeah. Oh my head. Yeah. That's J.S. Jagr coming out trying to make himself look big. That's a real marginal call.
To me, there's no call.
Yeah, I don't like that call at all. It's like, see him coming across. He's going with the flow of the puck.
Now, is he allowing J.S. Jagr an opportunity to stop the puck? And the reaction from Mike Babcock, Paul McLean, assistant coach in the background.
Zetterberg back to the line to Lilia. Feeds off to Hoodman. Back to Zetterberg. Holmstrom in front. The shot scores! Henrik Zetterberg, they're saying no goal because Tomas Holmstrom's going to go to the box for interfering with Michael Tellqvist, and Larry will have to see it again. He gets no breaks when he's near the periphery of the crease whatsoever.
Well, looking at his reaction, you can see that he does not agree with the call. Tomas Holmstrom is camped out front as usual. Henrik Zetterberg comes off the post.
Now where was it?
Well, he was just holding his ground.
Now why?
Sharnquist was
basically
pushing him back.
Didn't touch him. Didn't touch him. Look at Tomas Holmstrom saying, look where my feet are. I'm not in the crease. I didn't touch the goalie.
Pulled him into him. That was hot. Given on to Zetterberg. A cross number. That's a good shot. He scores! And it is wiped out.
The shot by Datsyuk. There's Tomas Holmstrom. Watch where his heels are. They're out on top. Now take a look at the overhead. Wow.
And I'm wondering, Glenn, is this a reputation call?
They blew it in game one, but they also have blown it here in game four. If you're outside the crease, you can establish your position. And if you look where Holmstrom is, he is outside the crease. So that should be a goal. Game one, different story. The third goal of the game should have been disallowed, wasn't. and they got away with one there.
Through the center zone by the Sharks, he goes deep. Antoniemi can't control. Holmstrom gets to it. Kotsuk winds it back. Ruslan Saleh, a wrister off a stick, off Ryan Klo. Another penalty out in front.
You expected to see in this period?
No question. I expect them to keep competing here. This is a huge kill for us right here, obviously. I didn't think that was a penalty. I mean, straightforward, but they were complaining about them before. That's the way it goes. We need a big kill right now.
Thanks a lot. Guys.
Thank you, Lindsay. The candid Mike Mack. We love it, don't we?
I'm going to try to Q-Fest.
Mark that down.
Tried it again. Here's Datsuk. Datsuk doesn't shoot it. Here's Zetterberg. Penalty over. Takes the shot.
Another penalty. Oh, to Detroit this time. Who will it be to Holmstrom?
Yep. Interference.
On who? The goalie or the defenseman? Homer is just...
I think it's goalie interference.
Find where it is.
He got his stick there.
Well, I tell you what.
It was the shaft of Thomas's stick that Holmstrom's stick knocked.
It is a game of hockey. I just get so irritated at this chintzy garbage that's being called. It's hockey, for goodness sake. God. Terrible.
I wonder what the guys in the other booth are saying.
Well, I mean, I don't care who it's against. It's awful for the game. I mean, it can't be called no matter who it's on.
Goal-scoring funk.
Well, I mean, he does so many things well.
The shot by Hudler. Oh, and he'll have you going up high. And then
look at
he gets called over. It's going to be a penalty coming up here to Holmstrom.
This is a reputation call, I'd say. Oh, look out. He could get more. Homer says,
Well, 999 career games, he's had a few of those calls.
Yes, he has. You be the ref. Oh, geez.
I'd say that was a pretty good shove, wouldn't you?
It's laughable. It's the reputation call. Holy mackerel. How can you not see the Edmonton defenseman, Whitney?
Yeah, I mean, and he knows
that's
enough
ridiculous.
On reputation, too. Wouldn't Thomas Holmstrom know that he's going to get called if he doesn't? He's got to stay out of there?
Well, he did his best.
Right.
He had his hands up in the air like he was, I give.
Yeah.
And Whitney drilled him, and the referee obviously was ordering his pizza.
We're in the same grouping. Lidstrom. For Datsuk, we got a penalty upcoming
Holmstrom.
To Detroit.
Yeah. Well, you couldn't hide long enough, Homer. Your reputation got him in trouble there. And it'll be an interference call. We go 4-on-4 with 1:07 left in the Boyle penalty. That's how Homer feels if you're reading lips. That wasn't very nice, ref, he said.
Well, from the goals that Thomas Holmstrom's had called back by Dan O'Halloran in his career, and I remember specifically against the Ducks, he should know that, well, Dan knows all about him.
He gave the guy a shove. He's complained about it.
Swung by Stahl, kept by Datsuk. Lidstrom a shot, he scores! And it's waved off!
Well, what a pass by Pavel Datsuk. There's Holmstrom, the left part of your screen. He gets to the front of the net, and you see the referee just waving. I'm not sure where the interference came. Well, maybe the stick there, maybe the stick between the legs, Doc, did not allow Marc-Andre Fleury to do his job. The stick got caught in between the legs, so no goal and a penalty to Tomas Holmstrom. Again, if you're that forward in front of that Tomas Holmstrom, you must allow the goaltender to make a stop on the plate. Fleury comes out of the crease. The stick does get in between, but I don't like this call. I do not agree with this call as goaltender interference. And Mike Babcock obviously feels the same way.
Tomas, take us through that first play. I'm sure you've been asked a number of times already, but what happened on that first play when you were called for a penalty and the goal was waved off?
Yeah, I haven't seen it myself, really, but it was a bad call. Fleury went out to me and he left the crease, and it was a tough break for us. It was a big goal and disallowed, so really frustrating, but huge. So Sammy come back and they scored first and second goal for us, and yeah.
Do you think you're a little bit of a marked man now, it seems?
What do you think?
I think yes. What do you think?
I hope. Yeah, I don't know what to think anymore. It's, you know, I try to stay up the crease, and they still disallow the goal, so it's tough. But for sure, it helps out me win the game.
Taken off the backboards, Franzen skips a man, Lilia walks in, fires one wide. Anderson was dumped in the crease. There's a penalty call coming here.
Brilliant toe save of this period by Anderson. Here's Holmstrom. There's Anderson with a little play acting. A little dinner theater acting for you by the netminder, Craig Anderson. He's battling. Oh, look at what happened to me. He ends up face down.
Leaned on enough by Hossa that he forced him to slow down. Datsyuk delivers a pass on over to Franzen, sets it back up. Rafalski a shot. And we have a goaltender careening over in front of the net. We have both calls being made, one to Detroit and one to Chicago.
There's Holmstrom. He's battling. Gets helped in a little bit there by Kim Janssen. And both these goaltenders have felt some bumping, and they've sold it to the referees at some point. If you're a referee, you got to take control and say, look, enough with the embellishing. Call a dive on a goaltender, and then they're not going to do that anymore. But certainly there was a lot of battling in front of the net.
Careful not to hold him. Back to the line to Lidstrom. Shot just wide. Holmstrom on the rebound. Couldn't bury that.
Another penalty coming. Who's getting it? Holmstrom? Oh, my. Oh, you're not going to like it. Look at that.
Boy, Gleason's taking about five shoves at him.
And Holmstrom, for the second home game in a row, is, looks like going to get another. I mean, penalty. Now, Leeson's going to the box, but they didn't blow this whistle until Detroit touched the puck.
I can't see.
Well, that can't be by that replay, it cannot be a penalty to Holmstrom. But you know what? He's going, and that's unbelievable.
Well, Gleason drives him right into the Cam Ward.
Awful, awful.
Tomas Holmstrom showed great restraint to try not to get an extra, and he ends up in the box too.
That's a pretty amazing call. He got drilled in the back. We'll show it again. He got cross-checked big time right in the back into the goalie. Now you tell me, where's the goalie interference?
They called Gleason for interference there, and now they're going to call Holmstrom for roughing.
That's roughing. Yeah, I don't think he got his money's worth if he called him roughing. Holy jumping.
Could live with 4-2, but not 2-2.
Let's correct what we just said. Tomas Holmstrom got interference.
That's right.
Gleason
thought.
Got roughing.
I know. Ludicrous. And I mean to the nth degree. Yeah. Ludicrous.
Call. There's no way Holmstrom could have held out without going into Ward on that one. And we know Holmstrom will sometimes give it a little bit extra, but that one he couldn't have stopped.
No one in front. Now Holmstrom heads there.
He wants to switch his Lidstrom. There it is.
Zetterberg in front for Holmstrom. Penalty upcoming.
Another penalty? What do we got?
It will be a penalty.
Detroit, okay.
Holmstrom, interference. Remember in the old days when these just used to be battles in front of the net?
Yeah. But if you're going to stay in the game, you got to get used to that. That was it?
Wow. That is a battle in front. He's looking for a puck, is he not? He's reaching for a puck.
I guess you can argue against those full of cows from home, but
I hope they come home already.
Can you do? Sometimes they don't. They get lost.
Is that what happens?
Sometimes these balls are getting lost.